How can we leverage social media in 2019 so every single soul in our town knows about our restaurant? Our greatest enemy in the restaurant business is obscurity, and social media can be a cure. But if you're continuing to use social media like it's 2017, you're most likely are not maximizing the potential of this powerful tool. Because the truth is, things have changed a bunch in the last couple of years, and it may be that you're losing money on social media, on ads, and you're feeling a little bit frustrated. Today, I'm excited to talk to you about how social media has changed in the last few years. I'll share with you three things that used to work that no longer work. So if you're using this tool in the wrong way, let's fix that, let's stop that, and use it the right way so we can be effective and get the best results. We'll talk about seven things that do indeed work like a charm on social media marketing for our restaurants in 2019. Last but not least, we're going to talk about Facebook ads. I'm going to share with you what is working with Facebook ads and what is not working with Facebook ads today. So again, how we're going to maximize this tool to make some dough, people, to grow our sales. Because obviously we're in this business to make a profit. This is Making Dough Show. You can find us on YouTube and all podcast platforms. My husband and I own a couple restaurants in the San Antonio area. And we want to help you, fellow restaurant owner or manager, own and run a profitable restaurant that does not own you. On this show, we talk about restaurant marketing, management, we get to answer your questions, and much more. So if this is your first time, consider subscribing. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram. If there is any way that we can be of help in helping you crush your sales, be sure to send me an email to makingdoughshow@gmail.com. If you got any questions, I'd be happy to cover them in a future episode. Also, you're welcome to go to our website, www.makingdoughshow.com, and download a few free resources we have for you, particularly one that is called The Ultimate Restaurant Marketing Guide. It's a free PDF. I share with you all the many ways, in fact, 52 different ways, one idea per week for the whole year where you can use and grow your sales. These are the ways that we've used in the last few years and continue to use to get results and grow our sales. So I hope it serves you. Now let's dive into the show. We have a lot to talk about. Do you remember just a few years ago, our focus was always to get folks to follow us, to like us on social media? How exciting it was when we hit like 500 followers or 1,000 or 5,000 or whatever it's been. It was exciting times, partly because we felt very popular. The number of followers you had on social media mattered a few years ago, because back then everything that you posted would be shown to majority of your followers. In fact, there was a time it was 100%, then it went to like 90% plus followers. Every single person that followed you would see every single post that we posted. Those were the good old days. In 2019, however, the likes and the shares and the comments we get, it's considered vanity metrics. In fact, the number of followers a restaurant or a business has on social media literally means nothing. And that is the first thing that no longer works on social media. If you are a new restaurant owner, maybe you opened in the last couple of years and you don't have many followers on social media and you know that that doesn't look good, know that if your focus is just to grow your audience and you think that that's going to reflect directly on your sales, you're going to get disappointed. Because it's going to be a lot of effort for you to get people to follow you on these social media platforms. And then maybe 5 to 10% of your followers would see your posts. So as I mentioned a few years ago, every single post that you posted on social media would used to be shown to all of your followers. Then what marketers would tell us is that you got to post a lot. You got to post every single day. You got to post 3 times a day. Then there were all these social media agencies that popped up that they would contact us and say, hey, I will post on your behalf and I charge $300 a month. You know how important it is to post on your social media. I will post for you and charge a lot of money. Yes, friend, I got sold to. We paid a company for like 3 months for like $350 a month for them to post on our behalf on our social media platforms. And I remember because a guy would tell us, oh, we have this algorithm that calculates the effectiveness of when to post and this and this and that. And our algorithm says that you need to post like 3 times a week. That's the best thing because you don't want to bug your followers and blah, 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 and what have you. That no longer works. If you're just paying a social media agency company just to post for you, that no longer works. Anyways, that no longer works. You should know that, because majority of your posts are not going to be seen by your followers. Again, Facebook and Instagram, both their algorithm shows maybe 5 to 10% of your followers will see your posts, depending on the size of your page. On the other hand, if you know your social media organic is reach is down, and you think that, oh, I'm just going to, you know, I have all these bunch of posts from months and months ago, and I'm going to reuse them and repost them over and over, know that that does not work either. Because people are on social media to get entertained. You are also on social media yourself, most likely, to get entertained. We cannot be boring on social media. All of our customers are bombarded on a daily basis with messaging, with ads. And when it comes to our industry, we're competing with other restaurants, maybe with their ads and the content that they put out. And you know that a lot of these restaurants are multi-billion dollar companies with multi-million dollar budgets. In fact, they have marketing departments, they have content creation department, what have you. You know, they have videographers. I don't know. They have departments for those. They have branding departments. We don't have that. We don't have their budget, but we can be creative and we can be strategic. Enough talk about what does not work. I'm going to share with you 7 things that do indeed work, so you can use them to your advantage in 2019 while they still work and make some dough. If you have not already, be sure to visit our website, www.makingdoughshow.com, and grab your freebie, The Ultimate Restaurant Marketing Guide, where I go over 52 different ways that you can use to grow your restaurant. Again, those are all the many ways that we currently use to grow our restaurant sales day in and day out. So go there and grab that if you have not already. Now let's get back to the show. 7 things that do work in 2019 when it comes to social media and growing your restaurant sales. First, do less better. In 2019, it is better to post less than more. It's better to create 2 posts that draws attention, that engages your audience, than creating 10 posts that are boring, that is just does not stop people on the scroll, right? They're just scrolling, and it's just kind of this boring post that it does not compel them to take action. It is not memorable. So again, it's better to do less, but do a better job than creating far too many posts that are not really effective and not getting you results. The second thing that continues to work in 2019 when it comes to social media marketing for your restaurant is having longer captions. So your caption is the text associated with your post, whether it's on Instagram or on Facebook, it doesn't matter. You know, you have that section, the text part. So here's a question I have for you. And I would love to hear your thoughts. How are your captions currently? Are they like a one-liner, two-liner, or you actually take the time and go a little bit of depth? You tell a story that, again, people read and they remember it. It makes them feel something. It compels them to take action or leave a comment. Are your captions funny, entertaining? Are they educational? Are you sharing something that maybe they did not know? Do your captions build your brand? Are you deepening your relationship with your customers with every single post? How do they feel after reading your caption? Will they remember your post in 10 minutes? Is there a singular purpose behind the post that you're posting right now, behind your captions? We are in business, friend, and the restaurant business is cutthroat. We need to be strategic and we need to be effective and do less better. So as I mentioned, longer captions work. And especially if you're telling a story, you're sharing like maybe about an event you hosted, what was special about it, you know, take people behind the scene. If you're sharing a post about your, like some of your ingredients, share why you chose those ingredients, why they matter, where they come from. If you share posts about your people, maybe say, hey, this is John. John is a college student. He's a psychology major at our local university. He's passionate about this. He's been part of our team for this many. We love him for this aspect. He's behind, you know, he's the one who came up with that dish. I don't know. You know what I mean? Tell stories so people feel connected to your brand. Make sure that your captions are like a conversation that you're having with your customers, casual and friendly. We're not a corporation. You know, even if you're a corporation, when it comes to a restaurant, you're a big franchise company, you need to view, you're on social media, you're dealing with people on a one-on-one basis, right? As a person who's going to read your post. Be friendly, be casual. Don't be like corporate rigid, you know what I mean? Which perfectly leads to the third thing that does indeed work when it comes to social media for your restaurant in 2019, and that is to go wide and deep. Many of our social media efforts is to go wide. We want thousands of people to see our posts. We just get excited, oh, our post had 2,500 reach. If that is your focus, you're simply going wide. And a lot of times that doesn't necessarily translate into sales, and you may have already discovered that. It is critical to also go deep. I'm not saying it's wrong to go wide. We do use Facebook ads many times, and I do look at the reach because we want to make sure that a lot of people see our posts. We want thousands of people to know our restaurants exist because we need thousands of customers to pay for our overhead and hopefully leave us a profit. In 2019, if you don't have a strategy to also go deep, you are missing out. Deeper relationships on a one-on-one basis. You need to be responding to every activity on your page. That means every comment, every share, every check-in, every recommendation, anybody who tags you, just DM them. Introduce yourself, who you are, thank them for whatever they did. If there's any way that you can serve them better, you know, get that dialogue going on a one-on-one basis. A lot of times your customers can give you great insight that you never knew. We actually have been able to build a lot of relationship online with our customers in a way that even if there is, even when there is, obviously there is sometimes that we screw up, they directly message us instead of putting it publicly because they know that we respond to every single comment. They know that our page is alive, right? That we're present. We're not just posting static. There's no comments. There is no comment to the comment, right? They know that we're present and active on our social media. So when there is an issue, they simply directly send us a message and we immediately, in fact, I think any comment you need to address immediately, if not within 24 hours max, responding to every comment, every message. Our goal is to go wide and deep. And again, get a lot of followers and turn those followers into allies and even friends. Step number four in what works when it comes to social media marketing in 2019 is stopping the scroll. It is critical that we use media, whether it's photos or videos, that stops the scroll, that draws attention to someone who's scrolling. They're like, whoa, what's this, right? Here are a few quick tips how you can also stop the scroll with your social media posts. Simple one is adding texts on your photos, on your images before you share them. What happens is, you know, a lot of friends and families you have on social media, they share a lot of posts and images or photos and videos, but usually there's no text on it. So if you just have text on the image and you put, again, like a darker background, the letters are lighter, it's easier, it'll catch the attention of the eye of the person who's scrolling. You can use a free tool like canva.com. You can get the app, it's free. And you can create templates. It is so easy to use to put text on images. With text on images, you want to provoke curiosity. Say less. You can, you know, ask even a question where it'll draw the attention of the person who sees the post to stop the scroll and be like, oh, what's this? And goes and reads the caption. And we talked about the caption. It's important that it's heartfelt, that it's deep, that it's genuine, that we tell a story. Maybe we're funny, right? So when you put the text on it, say less. But so, for instance, one of the examples I can say is that I just this last week created a birthday campaign for a Facebook birthday campaign for our restaurants. So what I'm able to do is, thanks to Facebook, is show a post only to people whose birthday is in the next week and to those people. And so maybe on the text that's on the image that says, is your birthday coming up? Or you want a free birthday pizza, right? So people whose birthday is coming up, they already are thinking about their birthday. It's a fact. So when they see the word birthday on the text, they're like, hold up, how did you know my birthday is coming up, right? That's what they're thinking. In fact, a lot of times the caption for our birthday ad, it says, we know your birthday is coming up and we wanted to treat you to this and that. You know what I mean? So putting a text that is few words, but stops the scroll and like, oh, what's going on in here? That is very effective in 2019. So here's a question I have for you. How are the visuals that you're sharing right now on social media? What's the one thing you can do to improve in that? If you're going to have 100 people who your reach is 100 people who saw your post, out of those 100 people, how many people are you able to stop the scroll, right? To draw that attention, you know, what are some of the ways that you can do that? I would love to hear your thoughts. If you're watching this on YouTube, you can comment below and let me know what areas you can improve on the images that you're currently showing and posting on your social media. The fifth thing that does indeed work when it comes to social media marketing for your restaurant in 2019 is batch scheduling your posts. I know you're busy and maybe the only time you have time to post on social media, it's maybe on a 3 p.m. on a Tuesday. That's around the time that you're going to receive the food order or place the food order and Susan called in sick and you're like, we've not posted on social in the last 2 days and it's time to post something. If that's what you're doing, friend, you're not being as effective as you can be and you're simply adding to your stress because you're not working smart. You are indeed working hard. I strongly recommend you batch create your social media. You sit down once, spend 2 hours and create 30 different posts and in one sitting, you're done. You can use a third-party website like Buffer or Later.com. There are many websites that are part of this social media scheduling stuff, or you can simply use the free scheduler in Facebook. Whenever you go post something on Facebook, you can publish it or schedule it right there. And I use that. I also use a third-party platform to schedule our social media. Stay tuned because in the next few weeks, I'm going to share with you how I spend less than 1 hour creating all of our social media posts per month, less than an hour per month. And the reason is because I have a photo bank, I have a video bank of all of our dishes, all of our people, the different events we host. So I have all the media that it's like a bank I have. I also have multiple Google Docs with multiple caption bank of stories and different things I already have created previously. And some of them I use, I change here and there and I mix and match. And I've created that. And now monthly, it's much easier for me. I spend less than an hour to schedule our social media for the month. Let me know if you're interested in hearing more about that and how I do that. If you got specific questions about that, send me an email to makingdoughshow@gmail.com and I'll be sure to answer your question right here. When you batch schedule your posts, you can be way more strategic. You're being proactive and looking at the whole week. You're looking at the whole month. You know the promotions that are coming up. Like it's February, you know Super Bowl is coming up. You know Valentine's coming up, right? So that's a time that you are mapping out your promotions and your social media and your marketing and all of that. You're looking ahead. You're batch creating it ahead of time and you setting it up and you're automating it. We can do that in 2019, friend, and we gotta take advantage of automation. The sixth thing that does indeed work in 2019 when it comes to your social media is being active in your local Facebook group communities. We are obsessed with our local Facebook groups because they do indeed work. We have multiple Facebook groups in 3 to 5 mile radius of our restaurant. One of them has 23,000 members there. And every post gets dozens and dozens of comments because people are active on Facebook groups and Facebook as a platform favors Facebook group posts. So posts from pages that people have liked may not be shown to people, but groups that people are following, they're more likely to see the posts from the groups. Many of those Facebook groups have specific days and time that they allow businesses to post stuff about their business. I went into way in depth about, you know, how to use and leverage Facebook groups for your restaurant, how to watch your competitors, how to see what feedback they're getting, you're getting, and different ways you can market on Facebook group that are not like your standard way in a previous show. I'm going to link it down below so you can see that. Facebook groups are free. They do work, and I strongly recommend you taking advantage of them today, since today they work. You never know what tomorrow holds. The seventh thing is Facebook ads. You've got to have a strategy and a budget when it comes to Facebook ads. In 2019, Facebook ads work well when done right. Your goal isn't to boost just to boost to get reach. That's the wrong way of using that tool. It's just like a knife, you know, you can use the knife on the sharp side or on the dull side. Maybe if you use it on the dull side, it works somewhat, but it's not the most effective way of using that knife as a tool. Same as with Facebook ads. A lot of folks have them, you know, make the mistake of not tracking things properly when it comes to their Facebook ads. They don't even know how to track it. You know, they don't put proper promo codes in place. The metrics that you're measuring the effectiveness of your Facebook ads may be wrong, and that's why you think that Facebook ads don't work. You are spending money on Facebook ads. If you're doing that, you need to have a proper strategy. Facebook ads work to help you grow your database, your email list, your text database. There must be an incentive in place, a reason why people would give you and me their email addresses or their cell phone numbers. I do, but I don't necessarily use our Facebook ad platform to grow our sales, but rather I use it to grow our database of our customers. And I send them weekly emails and I send weekly text messages. And I'm trying to be strategic with those in that one, I'm being consistent. Every email that we send out is being educational. There's like a family deal and there is an entertainment section. So people are more likely to open. So we have higher open rate on our emails. That's where we make our money. So as I grow our database to 5,000, 7,000, 10,000 plus customers on a weekly basis, I can be in front of them because I'm not looking for a peak of sales that I have one like Super Bowl or one Valentine's Day or what have you as a promotion that, yay, that's not our way of growing our sales. I'm pursuing steady growth. I want steadily our daily average to go up because that's where you get momentum. Do you know what I mean? That's how you get momentum. You're simply adding customers to your database and to your community of people who are exposed to you. 10 customers a day, 20 customers a day, and that will get you momentum in good time. And that is how has been our strategy when it comes to growing our sales. You know that all the social media platforms may go away one day. Who knows, right? They could all go away. And if you're just building your audience on social media and you're not building your email list, you're not building your database of your text message database, you are walking on, I don't know what it is, on water, on ice. I don't know what the terminology is. You're not being effective. As a business owner, you need to have a long-term view. You know that these social media, they can go away. The organic reach, you know, it went down. Now it's like 5%, as I'm telling you. Who knows? It could go down to 1%. So what's the point of having all those followers who are not going to see your post? So what, every time that you post, you have to pay Facebook so people would see that post? That is not really effective. And our profit margin is really low for us to have that strategy. And you know that. Instead, you need to view Facebook ads as a fishing net. Facebook gives us access to the pond, and everybody's hanging out at the pond. Our customers, everybody is on social media, right? They're hanging out there at the pond. They may not know us, they may have heard about us, I don't know. But our goal is when the way we use Facebook ads is to view that as a fishing net where we go into the Facebook pond, we throw the net, we grab the people and the or fishes, you know what I'm talking about, and we release them in our pond. So you are actually in the catch and release business, friend. We want to feed them in our pond. We want to feed them and fat them up. You know what I'm saying? You know, we're in the restaurant business, but you get my joke. Here's the truth. Currently, we're at a stage that even if all social media goes away and we stop posting anything on social media ever, for the next year, and I don't spend a dollar on Facebook ads or any kind of ad. If I stop spending money on any ads, we'll steadily grow our sales 10% or more month after month because we have a database of over 10,000 customers that hear from us every single week. So here's my question, friend. How are you using Facebook ads? What's working for you? What's not working for you? Have you viewed Facebook ads as that fishing net that I'm talking about? That you go to the Facebook pond, you get all the fishes and you bring them into your pond, your own pond, where you are controlling the dialogue. You're controlling who sees your posts and not, without needing to pay Facebook every time that you post something in order for people to see it. I'm curious to know the size of your database. I would love to hear that. If you're watching this on YouTube, you can comment below and just with the number of followers you have on social media versus the number of people, the number of your email addresses in your database or the number of phone numbers in your text database. If you're listening on the podcast, you can always send me an email to makingdoughshow@gmail.com. I would love to hear where you're at and what your plan is, where you should take it, and how are you going to get there. Budget-wise, you can start as low as $10 a day. It's critical that you have a tangible way of tracking and seeing if the strategy in place does work or not. If you need help with any of this, if you have any questions, you would like me to go into more depth into any of the stuff that we talked about today, I would love to hear your thoughts. Again, send me an email. We can get the chat going. If you have any questions, you can also go to our website, scroll all the way down to makingdoughshow.com. Scroll all the way down and there's a section where you can submit your question. I would love to cover it in a future show. Hope this show was insightful and helping you get some clarity as to how you can take advantage of social media to grow your sales and make some dough. I cannot emphasize it enough. You and I need to stay focused on growing our sales day in and day out. And no matter who doesn't show up to the shift, no matter who quits, no matter what customer complaint you get, stay focused on growing your sales, because that can reduce a lot of the stress. Thank you so much for tuning into another show. Be sure to subscribe if you have not. And I will see you next week right here on Making Dough Show. Out. Bye.